Right, so now here for your grammar exercises, let us do this question here. Look at the question, please. A doctor dashed the habit of talking to the trees on the roadside as he took his walk in the evening. He would dash to kiss the trees lovingly and whisper kind words to them. This dash, an odd but a beautiful sight. It was indeed a noble act in this wicked world. One day he was very dashed to see one of his trees cut down. The dash lover was so upset that he collapsed on the road. Right? So as I said, this is something that we have to be really very worried about. It's about nature. And how we are cutting down the trees so recklessly, and we need to take care of them. So it's very rare that we come across people who are there very concerned about nature and express their love for them. So this, this paragraph, it's about a nature lover, right? So doctor would go for evening walk, would kiss the trees and whisper kind words to them, right? And yes, talk to them, say thank you to them, and be thankful for the blessings that we get from the trees. Now, please look at the paragraph. There are options there, multiple choices. Oh, we love these kinds of questions where there are multiple choices, don't we? Right. And yes, here, yeah, let's go through the answers. A doctor dashed the habit of talking to the trees on the roadside as he took his walk in the evening. What are the options? Has, had, with, have. A doctor has? No, this is, we are implying it to everybody, isn't it? Right? A doctor had the habit of talk. Write down all the answers that then send me. I don't want your responses one by one. My chat box is overflowing with your responses here. So no, we will write down all the answers. Write down all the answers that then send to me, not one by one. A doctor had, it's not has. Has is wrong. So here we're generalizing it. A doctor had the habit of talking to the trees on the roadside as he took his walk in the evening. He would dash to kiss the trees lovingly and whisper kind words to them. He would bend. He would bend, right? Not bent or bending. So they are absolutely wrong. He would bend to kiss the trees lovingly. Yes. And whisper kind words to them, bent. This dash, an odd but a beautiful sight. This dash. This is an odd but a beautiful sight. This has been, this was, this could to be. Could to be is absolutely wrong. It is so grammatically incorrect. What was it? What was the answer? This was an odd but a beautiful sight. It was indeed a noble act in this wicked world. One day he was very dash to see one of his trees cut down. He was very amused, he was upset, he was eager, he was jovial. He was upset. Yes, you got the right answer. Very good. You can raise your hand here. He was upset. The dash lover, the flower lover, the evening lover, the fruit lover, the nature lover, the nature lover. Yes. Now, so what are the correct answers? Who's going to tell me? Someone raise a hand and give me the correct options. Yes, so Shivansh, please give me the correct answers. So had, bent, was, upset, nature. These are the correct answers. Did you get the correct answers? All of you, how many got the answers correct? How many got the answers correct? C is was. This was an odd sight. Yes, right? Okay, fine. Answer B is bent. He would bend to kiss the trees lovingly. Bend. Jukna. Right? Yes. Would bend to So what are the answers? Had, bent, was, upset, nature. Okay, now, yes, yeah. Next one is, the fact is I'm not dash pleased with your performance this year. Supply a suitable determiner. Dhruv is there in the class today? Dhruv? Harshika? No, they are not there. Dhruv is here? Let me just have a look. Yes, okay, very nice. Good, Dhruv is there. Very nice. Okay, yes. Now look at this option. What are determiners? We have discussed determiners. See, the grammar syllabus is the same. What it was in term one, it is the same in term two. Writing skills are different, your literature is different. So grammar is the same. Whatever we had done in the first term, it's going to be a repetition in the second also. Okay, right. So now I have shared the syllabus with you also. The fact is, I'm not dash pleased with your performance this year. Supply a suitable determiner. What could be the answer? I am not dash. That we don't write, we'll not write. I'm not that pleased. We use it, but right. So determiner, it determines the meaning. You know, like, yes. What would it be? I am not. How pleased? Pleased, it's a, is it, what is it going to be? A countable or an uncountable noun we're going to use? So pleasure, can you measure your pleasure? Can you, right? I'm not very pleased, is it? More pleased, much pleased, enough pleased? What could be the answer? I've given you hints also. Now can you tell me? Yes. Much, very right, absolutely. I am not much pleased with your performance this year. As in a quantity, isn't it? Right, so pleasure is uncountable, and yes, so right. We can't put a quantity to it, we can't put a figure to it. So I am not much pleased with your performance this year. Bread and butter, a tasty breakfast. Supply a suitable verb. Bread and butter, it is taken together. It is as one. Right. Is it going to be bread and butter are? No. Because we don't take bread separately, don't take butter separately. Right? Yes, so bread and butter is a tasty breakfast. Now, this is something, what you can say, new, anything, right? Now, when we do editing, as I have told you, we have editing for errors. There is an incorrect word, we have to correct it, okay? Or there is a word missing, we have to supply the missing word. Remember, the format that you have to follow. Okay. Now look, and obviously before you do any grammar exercise, read the question. Read the question. In addition for providing a sweet taste but flavor, sugar performs the variety of functions in food products. Sugar are used as a preservative. When we are doing these errors, yes, please, the words that are given, there is something wrong with them. We have to make sure that we make the correct changes. Okay. Now, underline the incorrect word, write the correct answer. In addition for providing a sweet taste but flavor. Yes, think. In addition to, right? And otherwise also, when we say addition, right? So in addition to the earlier, you know, chapters, these ones you have to learn, not in addition for, okay? So addition to, providing a sweet taste but flavor. So it is a taste also and a flavor, right? A sweet taste and flavor. Sugar, perform your subject verb agreement. Sugar performs. Sugar performs the variety of functions in food products. A variety of functions in food products. Sugar are used as a preservative. There's only one kind of sugar we're talking about. So, sugar is used as a preservative. Do you want me to write down the answers on the blackboard? Do you want me to? Or will you write down? Will you manage? Let me see now here. Yes, all of you, please note down. How are we going to do?
We will write. Here you have these columns. You have error. You have finish. What is the wrong word? For. What is the
correct answer to? In the second line,
what is it? But. What's the right answer?
And.
Sugar perform. For perform will be performs.
Right? The variety of functions.
The will be the.
Sugar are used.
Sugar is used.
This is how you will be writing your responses. Write the incorrect word. Write the correct word in front of it. All of you, please note down. I'll be sharing this grammar exercise with you so you can use it for practice. Okay? Right? Have you done this one? Yes, all of you got the answers? All of you got the answers correct? Give me a yes or no? Yeah, I'm getting responses. I'm getting many responses. So good. Okay, now we have two kinds of editing exercise. What are we supposed to do? Editing exercises are there where some mistakes are there. We have to correct it. Now this one was the first one, your error. You're editing it. Okay. Right? So there is a wrong word. We corrected it. We wrote it down. Isn't it? What is the next one? There is a missing word. This paragraph is given, but in the line, some word is missing. We have to provide the missing word. Okay? So you have, what is the format for this? This is the way it is written. You have the word, first of all, and where you're going to put that missing word, you will put a slash over there, right? If it is in your book. And if you're doing it in the exam, make sure you write the word before, you write the word after, and you have provided the missing word. Omissions kya hote hain? There's a word missing. What do we have to do? We have to supply the missing word, okay? Where will that word come in a sentence? You have to mention that also correctly. You have to mention it clear. Okay? Right? So you have to mention it clearly that where is that word going to come? How are you going to mention it? You're going to put a slash over there. Now, look at this paragraph. Look at this paragraph. One word has been omitted. Ants, social insects. It means that live in large colonies or groups. It can consist millions of ants. There are three kinds of ants per colony: the queen, female workers, and males. Right? Look at it. Write it in the proper format in your notebook. Show me your notebook. Yes. Don't text me now. You show me the notebook. Show me that you are writing the answers. Okay. So can I see the notebooks? Write down the answers and then show me. Yes. Write down the answers. Come on. Ants-social insect. There is something missing. It is incorrect. Ants are social insects. So I write ants over here. I'll write social over here. What is the missing word? Are. Ants are social insect. Right? It means that live in large colonies. That they live in. No, you're not texting me. No. You will show me a notebook after writing the answer. Let me see that you're writing over there also. I want a record of that also. Okay? Yes. Yes. It means that they live in large colonies. What is it? That they live. Okay? So, what is the missing word? They. The word before is that. Word after is live. In large colonies or groups, it can consist millions of ants. It can consist of millions of ants. Okay, so of over here. There are three kinds of ants a colony. There are three kinds of ants in a colony. The queen, female workers, and the males. Now I will write down the answers on the blackboard. Okay, for you all to note down and of course so that you have an exercise for with you all. Can I see a notebook first? Can I see a notebook, all of you? Yes? Show me a notebook, please. Okay, very good. Of course, I have the most sincere boy here. Yeah, we have Dhruv here showing, Harshit also. Yes? Is that a notebook, Harshit? Is it? Okay, so Jasleen is also writing. Very good, very nice. Nishtha is writing. Although it is not very clear, others are not listening at all. Very sad. Okay. So please write down. Yeah, Hardik, where are you? I want to see your notebook also. Yes, Imani is also showing you. Very good. And now in the proper format. So those of you who have not written, please note down. What do we write down? We have the word before. I have the word after. And we supply the missing word. Okay? Right. Look at it. Ants are social. When I read these lines, it should be meaningful. It's understood here. It means that they live in large colonies or groups. It can consist millions, consist of. Please underline the word so I know that. Millions of ants. There are three kinds of ants in a colony. So I have ants in a. Right? The clear, the queen, female workers, and the male. So we have your female workers. Is it clear? Yes, so I have done my written work. You also need to do your written work. Have you done this? Right. Okay. Now next is dialogue or conversation. And this is something new, right? And let's see, are there any changes which are there? Now, a dialogue or a conversation in an appropriate way, in a proper way. Look at this conversation. Look at this conversation. Yes. What is dash? I can't walk. Do you have the pain? I slipped this morning and dash. I will give you dash right now. Should I go for an x-ray? I don't dash. So it's a dialogue or a conversation between a doctor and a patient. What do you think the doctor is saying here? Can you complete this? Take 2 minutes, read it and complete it. I know you people are very good at conversations, right? Very talkative we are, isn't it? And so what are you going to say here? Your conversation with a doctor, what are you going to talk? What is, yes, the problem? Okay, so imagine there are two people here, right? So we could have done it as a role play in the class also, two people and talking, like if you had to tell the doctor, what is it? So what is the problem? Yes, let me see your responses. What is the disease? Read the whole thing. Yes, so what is your problem? I fell down. I can't walk. Yes. Right? Or I have pain, I can't walk. Where do you have the pain? Or how long do you have this pain, right? I slipped this morning and fell down, twisted my ankle, hurt my knee, anything. I will give you painkillers or I will give you medicine right now. Should I go for x-ray? I don't think so. Yes, what can we write here? Make sure that one dialogue, it is connected with the other. It should not be something, separate only or on its own. What is dash? What is your problem? I am in pain. I can't walk. Where do you have the pain? I slipped this morning and hurt my back, hurt my knee, right? It has to be some part of the leg only, isn't it? Because it's having problem walking. Clear? Can you write this? Can you do this? Yes. Okay, right. Fine. So please complete this as a dialogue, otherwise also. Right here. Yes. No doubt. Or write down the answers on your own. So it should be relevant. It should be relevant to what the situation is there. So you've gone to the doctor, you have pain, you can't walk. So obviously, where is the pain going to be? Yeah, so your back or your knee or leg, foot, some part of that has been hurt, right? So how long you've had this pain? And yes, what is the doctor going to give you? The doctor is going to give you medicine. Do you need an x-ray? I don't think so. Is this clear? Yes.